testing to see if I can record gameplay stuff and while I'm uploading a video to YouTube or the fuck out. I can never finish any of the other campaigns, but the only ever do is Knee Deep in the Dead. Which one is it? The first one. I played a lot of Brutal Doom, but even without Brutal Doom, it was still really fucking painful. I don't think people, like, have it. It's not really a thought you have at the front of your mind, but, like, Doom is still really fantastic. And I guess you don't really think about it because it's like, yeah, Doom. Of course it's still good. It's funny too because the new levels, the classic levels in the new Doom, like there's a bunch of classic levels where you can play like the modern controls and whatnot in the old levels of Doom. They're terrible. It's sad because they're so fucking terrible. And you go back and play this, and it's like, holy shit, this is a fantastic video. Excuse me. How come they all have like, look at that, it looks like a machine gun or something, and I've just got this pistol. I have a pistol, they all have machine guns. That's a weird Doom fix. Uh-oh. I want to blow him up. I killed that guy, but I didn't kill him in the way I wanted to. This music, too. There's an art to MIDI soundtracks. MIDI music. That's probably a fun experiment. Like, I love those, Atamataguchi, I think they're called. The band that does all chiptune music. Like, stuff like that has got to be, like, really fun, like, as a thing to challenge yourself as an artist. But, like, at the same time, like, it's weird because people do that kind of stuff today, and, like, they're making a choice. Like, they're deliberately restricting themselves to fit with the tool set that was available at the time. But back then, That was as good as they had. That was the pinnacle. That was the, you know, best technology available. So, like, they weren't... That's something I think about a lot with, like, sprite art nowadays. Sprite art nowadays, it's just people being like, I'm gonna make something that looks like an Atari bomb. Because, oh, it's stylistic. It's the retro style. Like, there was no retro style. They didn't make it look like that on purpose. They made it look like that because that was the best they could possibly have made it look like for what was available. They could have made it with better technology. They would have, but they couldn't because that was the best technology they had at the time. They weren't making it look like that on purpose. They were making it look like that, and they were using what the resources available to them at the time to try and make it look as good as they possibly could. Like, it wasn't, oh, I'm gonna make sprite art, it's, I'm gonna go make art. Whereas today, people are deliberately making it look shit on purpose. And I feel like that's sort of missing the spirit of it. I wish there was an option for always run, holding down the left trigger to run everywhere. That's why I hate going on like Steam game or even like PSN or whatever, and seeing just like games that are just, oh look, it's shitty retro sprite art. And it's like, no, just because it's sprite art doesn't mean it has to look like crap, you guys. You can make sprite art that looks good. Fuck. Like, sprite art doesn't have to automatically equal, you know, pseudo retro gart fucking Atari vomit garbage. That's something I loved in Doom. That guy, like, turned around and shot his buddy. You can trick the AI into fighting each other. That's actually a vital strategy at, like, one of the bosses later on. I never finished any of the other campaigns aside from this one. Because, like, I always get lost. Like, it becomes, like, the level design just becomes maze-worthy later on. I just have no idea where I'm supposed to go. I feel like you need a guide or something at some point. This game is awesome. I have so many bullets now, but the pistol sucks, so I'm just waiting until I get that chain gun. I have no idea how to get all the secrets in this game. Guide is pretty hard. I don't know how you'd be able to figure this shit out organically. You can literally have to... Pinky! Hey buddy! Hey, how you doing? Doing good. You'd literally have to like mash your face against every single wall in the game and press the use button. Fuck that. Haha. Friendly fire. Excuse me. Have a nice day. That's great. Arrows usually get a pretty good kill percentage. Yeah, this is my favorite. Why can't I shoot up? Come on, I'll shoot the barrels. Oh my god, odd. That's what I want. How sad was it that in the fucking video on the new Doom, I was like, which buttons reload? Right? Which button reload to the modern game industry? That's corrupted me. Come on, barrel. Wolfenstein had reloading and the it made sense to have reloading in that game. I guess Doom is a bit more prolific. Anyway, like Wolfenstein 3D, which was one of the games that we had on our old computer. So I actually did play way more Wolfenstein as a kid than I ever played Doom. I don't think I ever played Doom as a kid, but I played a ton of Wolfenstein. Oh, god. What has occurred? What has transpired here? Disturbing. Disturbing on multiple levels. What the fuck? I was worried about this. I guess one of them got out and the game was open so you kill all the nukes. So the game didn't know. A box of bullets. Call them clips anymore. You're supposed to call them magazines. Yeah, it's weird playing this after playing so much. It's still really good. It's like, oh no. They needed to have a story. Although I do like the stuff they did where it's like a sequel to Doom 2 and like the actions of the screen. Like it actually does feel like kind of a reverence. It feels like they're, you know, glamp like romanticizing the original Doom. It feels a lot like how Force Unleashed. No, what? In Force Awakens. How like you had the villain in that movie, like looking at the statue of Darth Vader and being like, I want to be as cool as you though. I want to be a cool villain like you. And it feels like that's what the new Doom is more like. Oh man, we wanna be a cool like you, the original Doom is so cool. How cool the original Doom was, you guys. It was so good. And this is one of those games where like it was made by such a small group of people that you can really see, like you like to say, like Nick likes to say, you can see the fingerprints, or usually the lack thereof. There are no fingerprints. Where like you can tell who made it and what they were into. Like they put so much of themselves into the game that it's like almost like a portrait of their interests. It's very much one of those kind of products. It was very much one of those where the guys made the kind of game they wanted to make and took everything that they were into at the time, through it all, and you can see their influences and their music. Like, one of the enemies in this is just a fucking beholder from D&D. Shit. Like, heavy metal music, D&D... Like, the name of the game comes from a fucking... What's his name? The Last Samurai. Oh my god, that's gonna fuck the shit out of me now. Where, like, it was a boom game. You, like, opened up a pool case, and they're like, what's that? And so it's like, a pool cube, and like, dude. And I always love that video of, like, if Doom was made today, and it's like thinly veiled by Call of Duty kind of thing. You don't actually know anything about how Doom was made and what it was. Like, if Doom was made today, guess what? It wouldn't have been made by, you know, a big AAA developer. It still would have been made by 7 guys in college, in their fucking, like, college computer lab. It would have been considered indie. It was considered indie. It was shared on shareware discs. Like, kids just shared their floppy disks of Doom. If it was made today, it still would have been made by someone else. It still would have been what it was. Although, like, it probably would have been like Game Maker or Blender or something like that. And it would have been uploaded to like Pirate Bay or something, you know? It wouldn't have been, you know, fucking Call of Duty. You're a fucking dumbass. What is this switching button? The doctor. I'm talking about this. I don't think I'm gonna do this. I might not. I mean, I might. It's just a test run. I want to see if I can record while I'm uploading. Like, that's gonna make my fucking make the footage explode. Oh, is fucking obliterative in Brutal Mode. Like, it slices people in fucking half and shit. This is what always happens. I know where to go to. Annoying. This is what always happens to me when I'm playing one of the other campaigns. Like Inferno or. Here we go. I'm playing like Knee Deep in the Dead. Any of the other campaigns, I always end up just getting fucking lost like that. I do like the new Doom, like Doom guy does actually get characterization. But it's like really subtle, like he doesn't have any dialogue, but you can still like get an understanding of what his character is through his actions. Very Samus Aran, actually. Like, there's a moment early on where, like, we had to do this for the betterment of mankind, and like, there's a dead body in the room where he's saying that, and Doom Guy just, like, subtly looks down at the dead body while he's saying that, and then, like, after he's done, like, oh, we did what we had to do for the sake of mankind or whatever speech. Doom Guy just fucking punches the computer screen like, fuck you. Jesus. And it's not a lot. Like, it's definitely not as much as, like, DJ Baskowitz got in Wolfenstein. Like, Wolfenstein needs to be commended for taking BJ Blazkowicz and making an actual character out of him. Because, like, BJ Blazkowicz is defined by, like, being in head at the bottom of the game. Even Doom Guy has more character than fucking BJ Blazkowicz did. I mean, like, you can see in the game, like, look at his little face. It's making, like, an angry face right there. That is more than fucking BJ ever had. Like, he makes little emotive faces when he finds a new weapon, and he's like, yeah, but it's supposed to be. And And then, you know, fucking Wolfenstein, the new ones come out. And BJ is just like fucking amazingly rendered. Like with like characterization. Not really an art. He doesn't really have a character art, but he's just really well written. Really awesome. And you know, I'm really glad Doom Guy didn't get character, like he got characterization, but he doesn't talk ever. And hey, actions speak louder than words, for sure. It's just really funny, like the routes that these franchises, like these revival franchises, have taken. Because like Wolfenstein and Doom were like a year of first-person shooters, both of them. Like Doom popularized it, but Wolfenstein was the original. And now like you play the new ones today, and you're like, how come this isn't what first? Like they're both very different. Like they're both FPSs, but they play differently. Here we go. And it's like, this is what shooters always should have been, but for some reason they stopped being this. Like, for some, like, it's Call of Duty. It's Call of Duty Modern Warfare, Call of Duty 4, Modern Warfare. Which is another one of those games that ruined video gaming. Because it was so good that it ruined video gaming. And it was so successful. Like, that was also, that came out around the time where gaming was becoming mainstream. Like in like 2005, 2007, when gaming really hit mainstream awareness. And with mainstream awareness came mainstream success, and with success came imitators. Very much like Halo. It all goes in. A lot of things where you're like, oh, that happened that one time. Oh, it happened again. Oh, it happened again. Oh, it happened again. Doom 3 and all, but fucking Painkiller. It was literally go to hell and kill a bunch of demons. It was literally Doom 3. Oh my god, what? I'm some weird issues with this. Aha! How both of those bullets blew up at the same time, because of course the guns in Doom are hit scan. It's, you know, where you point the gun and pull the trigger, and then anything that's underneath the crosshair when you pull that trigger instantaneously gets hit the second you pull the trigger. Which is funny because the imps and most of the enemies use projectiles, which is where, you know, they throw the fireball and it, you know, goes over to you, and you have time to get out of the way. And I talked about this in the video, but in the new Doom, every single enemy has projectile weapons, and you are the only, and all of your guns are hit scans. Fuck? What was that? Which is funny, because in the original Doom, all the those guys, they're also using hit scans. Those are not projectiles. funny because in the new Wolfenstein, none of the enemies use projectile weapons. They're all fixed guns. Which someone did a video about talking about that. The fuck keeps making that noise. Play this game with the fucking left trigger taped down or I like how you can sneak up on enemies. If they don't know you're there, you can get a hit off. Hey! Calm down. There's another one! You bitch! I'll fuck you up! I'll fuck your mother! He's not very attractive, so I don't know why I would do that. I hate sex. Like, there are problems with the relationship. And that was the only one. That joke for Deadpool is so fucking good. You look like an avocado had sex with another uglier avocado. And it wasn't like making love, it was hate sex. Like there are problems with the relationship and that was the only way to get through it without violence. it cracks me up. Anyway, how am I going? All the places. How do you know where to go next? Are there enemies that I need to hit? Yes, that's where you go. That's actually very counterintuitive when you think about, like, role-playing. Like, you'd think, well, okay, maybe not in Doom. But in any other game, you'd think, like, the logic of the person you are playing as, they would want to avoid confrontation whenever possible. Like, they want to not risk fighting people and getting killed. Really, that logic of go, like, where? How do you know where to go next? Find where all the people you need to kill really only makes sense when it's, like, a psychopath character, like Doom Guy, or like the Punisher. You know, someone who's bloodthirsty. In other, like, it's player logic, but it doesn't make sense in the universe, you know? Funny, like, game-isms, I guess you could say. Where the fuck was there a red key? Door. Like, Doom Guy, of course, he wants to go rip and tear. I mean, that's in a lot of games, where you're like, where do I go? Like, are there dead people here? Yes, I've been here. Let's go find more people to get into firefights with and shit. Blue, but I don't see any red key. Fuck I going? Look at this. What keeps making that fucking noise? How do I get down there? Oh, I know. It's probably isn't. This always what ends up happening. Where do I go? What do I do? There's the blue key. I don't usually have this kind of trouble when I'm playing Rural Doom for some reason. Here we go. Let's try and find our way back to that blue door. Oh, hello. How's everyone doing today? Good? Let me know if there's anything I can do to satisfy your needs. Okay. I am here to serve. Thrill. How people find all the secrets is beyond me. I have trouble just finding the regular route that you're supposed to go. Yeah. Final boss. For the shareware version, at least. It's pretty fucking cheap when you've been saving up your fucking rock all the time. Yep. New final boss, guys. Pretty tough. They took out a decent amount of my health, though. There's only like a few shots. Anyway, that's all for which one is this? Shores of Hell? No, next one, Shores of Hell. This is Knee Deep in the Dead. I never remember the fucking names. Let's go out with a bang. Knee Deep in the Dead, and then Shores of Hell, Infernal Record. Okay, that's Doom, everybody. Hopefully this video came out good, so I can record more videos while I'm uploading videos. That was the point of me doing this.